What's up, everybody? It's the Offspring, and this is Farming Simulator 17, camping and off-roading. Yes, I am so happy, guys. I've been literally working my butt off for you guys for the last week. If it wasn't videos, it was, converting and creating mods. But boy, oh boy, personally, I converted a lot of these mods, but some of them I can't release unless I have permissions. But I do have permissions, of course, for this guy right here, which took me a long time because, as you guys know, Mason and them usually do the modding side of the team and whatnot. But I did this friggin' sucker all by my lonesome. It took me a while to figure out the convert because the converts of 2015 to 2017 are a lot different than 2013 to 2015. And even though they have that automated thing, it really doesn't finish the job ever. And yeah, so what we're going to be releasing today, guys, is the Commander Camper RV. And also the four-wheeler right here, the Can-Am, or if you want to call it, what do they call it in here? I forget. Or do they? I think they actually might call it the Can-Am in this game, or it might just be the Lizard four-wheeler or something like that. Let's see what it says in the store. Okay, so it shows up as Can-Am. Okay, yeah, I guess it's just Can-Am ATV. Or Lizard, whatever. But yeah, this thing was a pain in the butt too. If you guys follow me on Facebook, which is Offspring Gaming, and Instagram is the same thing, and Snapchat is Skorkin, you saw that I friggin' oh my god, I swear, I thought the dude was like morphed into a human centipede, the character guy himself, which was crazy. I've never seen anything like that before. And actually, we're gonna back this dude up out the way. Another thing, guys, is you see that over there? What is that? That is a tundra. But yeah, guys, if we get a goal on this video, guys, we're going to be releasing the Tundras. And look, I'm gonna tell you guys this straight up right here. If we get the goal on this video, I have two versions of the Tundra. I have one 4x4 lifted, and I have this one right here, which is more of a two-wheel drive, even though it's got like nittos on it and the old freaking rocket stars. But yeah, guys, let's see if we can get... Okay, I know you guys can do this. Friggin' y'all blasted me away all summer long in August and whatnot. Let's see if we can get 800 likes on this video, guys. If we can get 800 likes on this video, I'm gonna release the friggin' Tundra for FS17 and FS15, both versions, guys. So you're literally getting four releases if we hit 800 likes. And guess what, guys? If we actually hit the goal, 800 likes, like I said, I'm going to release the two Tundras on both games, FS15 and FS17. But if we get the goal, just because I'm feeling awesome and stuff like that, and you guys are just amazing and I can't get over it. But if we get the goal on this video, I'm going to be releasing another mod. So how's that sound, guys? Five mods for a small goal of 800 likes, guys. And the reason why I asked them is because they help the channel out tremendously, and it helps me to be able to complete and release new mods for you guys. So yeah, guys, any subscriptions or likes or comments, they all help. And like I always say, the donation button on the homepage of the channel, it never goes in my pocket. It always goes back into the channel. Same with a lot of my personal income, believe it or not, because I'm the type of person who likes to invest back, you know what I mean? I don't care if I have a lot of pocket money. I'd rather invest it back into what I love doing and what you guys want, you know what I mean? Because you guys are amazing, and I literally, any chance I can give back to you guys and contribute to you, I do. But yeah, guys, check it out. This is our setup right here. I converted the trailer too. All these mods besides that Chevy over there I converted. Yeah, so we got the Commander RV, which Josh actually is modeling an interior for it, guys, that the slides will slide out. So tell me if that's not awesome, guys. And we also have an International 4700 coming your way that is completed on the model aspect of it. But the team is finishing in-gaming it, is what you call it, putting it in-game. Hope we don't lose the load, because the lock script, I couldn't get this lock script to work, guys, because I swear to God, like, I've been using kind of the stock equipment when the game first came out, and I never saw any lock scripts on the stock equipment. Maybe that might be because I guess the tie down straps replaced it, but still I can't get the tie down straps to work with a lot of stuff, so I end up losing a lot of loads personally, guys. So if any of you guys can give me any little insight about that on how I can get a locking script to work in FS17, and also you know, why my tie down straps don't work a lot. But yeah, guys, I think actually there is a camping area on this map. I could be wrong, and if I find it, we may end up jump cutting like close to it. See what I mean, guys? But actually, I take that back. The locking script on this thing does work, but the only thing. Whoa, hang on, let me glitched into this freaking thing. Well, it does kind of work, guys, because the ATV back there doesn't seem to move when I take turns and stuff like that. But this FJ, it's like it's floating on the clouds, guys. It's crazy. I don't like that kind. Oh, come on. Why did my I hate when it does this, guys. Like it didn't. It stopped doing this camera glitch. Like it was working fine when I first started recording this video. So I might have to jump cut, go into Giant's editor, and fix that before I use it in this video. And also because I gotta friggin' give it out to you guys, because I know you guys are wanting a four-wheeler, because what better combination to release with the Commander RV for this video you're watching right now than a ATV. And also, you know, the Tundras, you're getting four Tundras actually next, if we hit the goal on this video, four freaking Tundras, guys. That's crazy. And also another mod if we hit the goal, just because I'm all work. Y'all are awesome. And even if we don't hit the goal, guys, I'm gonna tell you straight up, just like how last time, if we don't hit the goal, I'll still end up releasing one or two of the mods anyway, you know what I mean? But the goals and stuff like that help us, you know, help us work, you know what I mean? Like, they help us work and they help us get mods to put in game and whatnot. Because, believe it or not, guys, models, like I've always said, cost a lot of money. What is that white over there? That's what she said. Oh, yeah, that's where we're going. I don't think, oh, yep, there's the bridge. I don't know if we can fit. Yeah, this is the 36-foot PJ bumper. Yeah, we're going to have to definitely, like, straighten up completely to where we're driving in there. And what do you guys want for next video? Most likely it's going to be the aux beam. Shout out to aux beam lighting. Next video is most likely, definitely going to be, unless there is an issue to where I have to upload an FS17 video. But yeah, guys, what should I make for my next FS17 video? I'd love to hear your suggestions, because I definitely need some suggestions. And hopefully me and Squad, I guess, are going to be releasing our collab and stuff soon, so look forward to that as well. Make sure to go tell him Offspring said, what's up? Always kind of want to do a let's play, I mean not a let's play, a freaking collab with Phoenix. I was actually going to do it, I think, at one time, because I saw when people asked that, but I don't know. I just, last time I remember, I asked him and stuff, but I never really heard back from him. I guess he was busy or something. I don't know. I know he's got chitchens, so that could be the issue. And he's doing his own little thing, you know what I mean? You don't need to be a little bothered with old Peyton, you know what I mean? Old little Peyton don't need to be bothered by him. Or, I mean, he don't need to be bothered by me. I'm just kidding. He's a cool dude. But, yeah, let's see. 4x4s. And I'm about to let's finish getting the stuff over to the area, then I'm going to do a little friggin' fancy magician jump cut and fix that ATV for the vidget, and also for you guys, because y'all are friggin' money. I love y'all big times, sick nasty. All right, check it out, guys. This is also going to be in the description of this video as well. Shout out to ATF James Hall. He's cool dude. He's pretty cool. He makes them good mods. I've never seen a Cheyenne badge on a new pick'em up truck, Chevy edition. Never seen that. Last time I saw me a Cheyenne lug, it was on my 1994 single cab gasser 1500 WT. Yeet. That's the last time I seen that Cheyenne logo, baby. Sucker didn't have mufflers or cats on it, baby. We called it the rag, not even joking. We called it the rag. I remember that truck. The whole friggin' back seat behind it was filled up with cigarette cartons. And then, because my dad used to own a business, like a couple businesses, construction businesses, and that's the reason why we still to this day have like friggin' buku friggin' diesel trucks still. Like, seriously, like, we have like, let's see. During the time of the business, we had like 15 or 20 diesel trucks, and you know, like I say, still to this day as well, we've always and still do only buy diesels. Even our cars, meaning like our passenger vehicle cars, are diesel as well. You know what I mean? Like, we got a Mercedes SUV that's like a 2014 sucker's diesel. Swear to God, it's pretty freaking boss. Look at the image, guys, in the front mirror to the right on the trailer. See the trees on it right there? See like the reflection or whatever? That's kind of weird. It looks like a freaking, somebody took like a old Polaroid picture and slapped it on there. All right, if I recall correctly, where we were going this way. I forget. I'm going all-timers on y'all, guys. Going all-timers. It was so funny. I was like talking about the ghost stuff, or like if the fact that like I believe in ghosts and like aliens and stuff last video, and asked if you guys did for the question of the day. It was so funny. I get some like question. I mean, some comments and stuff. I guess they were from like little kids, and they were like, "Oh no, don't talk about ghosts. That stuff scares me. I don't like that kind very much." And I was like, "I feel you." So I guess I'm not gonna be talking about friggin' ghosts no more. It's okay. I only did it for Halloween. How was your guys' Halloween? We're gonna cut through this field because I really wanted to test the terrain thing, because I heard, and I could have sworn I've seen it during playing this video, and I mean playing this game for videos and stuff like that, that the terrain, you know what I mean, like the terrain itself, like it's a lot upgraded. Like the, apparently like the sound of your truck changes when you're on different terrain, and also you know, when you're driving on terrain, like you don't have to have like the terrain mod or whatever it was in 2015. Like, remember how in 2015, guys, my game, like when I would go over bumps and stuff, it was like hella realistic and whatnot. Yeah, that was due to a terrain mod or whatever it was called, but apparently you don't need that kind anymore. But yeah, let's go ahead and park old schmiddly doodle. And actually, guys, after I do my little jump cut fixing that Can-Am over there, I probably gonna be back with a load trail trailer, because I'm trying to think of like mods besides mine that I can convert, because like I'm converting all my mods to release, you know what I mean, but like I'm kind of thinking, like I'm thinking about other mods, you know what I mean, like tell me, guys, like what other mods should I convert that like I could possibly, you know, get permissions to release, or the modder, you know what I mean, doesn't exist anymore or whatever, and I you know, I mean, just switching it over, you know what I mean, to FS17, because it wouldn't be like, I don't know, I mean, I could be wrong, you know what I mean, like I don't know, is it the same if I release the link to a friggin' mod, for instance, like the rollback trailer in FS15, and I link it to people playing FS15, even though it was already released, but Mudbone doesn't, you know, he quit life, you know what I mean, I'm just kidding, he quit Farm Sim. You guys, you just riled him up too much, I'm just kidding, I don't know the real reason why he quit, but he probably just got fed up and just wanted a break, you never know, he'll probably be back. Dude's been at this whole Farm Sim thing as long as I have. Me and old Mudbone been around since friggin' 2011 or 2012. I can't recall. It's been a friggin' minute. But yeah, guys, jump cut in half magician mode. I will be back in 2 seconds. Make sure to check out the like button while I'm doing this 1 second jump. Be right back. Okay, guys. Literally, I'm talking in the middle of that little pause that y'all had. I probably spent over 3 hours trying to figure out what was causing the issues with these mods and stuff. I fixed the dude and whatnot in the camera thing, and originally I was gonna get it on video, but then I remembered I have a screenshot of it on Facebook. My guy would be glitched and look literally like the human centipede. It's pretty crazy. I've never seen anything like that before, but I, you know, trying this a million times, like I said, it took me 3 hours just to get this Can-Am right here working right, and the controls to show up, because you know, with a lot of converts the controls won't show up in the top left. But you know, whoops, horn doesn't work. Nope, never mind, it works. Yeah, everything works actually, guys. Fire, yay, go Peyton. Yeah, so it's a lot different modding than I mean, Giants editor wise like, it's, you know, kind of same, but like, you know, they completely changed the XMLs in Farm Sim 17. So converting mods, yeah, may be a little bit easier, but it's also a little bit harder, just primarily due to the fact that this game is so new and everybody's still learning, you know what I mean? It's that's why you don't see too many mods out right now. And this is another thing I was working on in the last 3 to 4 hours, right here. Check it out. It is still a work in progress because Peyton's working on it, not Mason. Nobody else on the team's working on this right now besides freaking Peyton. And yeah, so and I don't, like, I really didn't mod much in 15, but I'm kind of like wanting to like kind of learn a little bit more into 17 to contribute and stuff. But my rims, look at my rims. They weren't black like this. They weren't blacked out like this. But check my tires out, guys. Very beautiful tires. Yeah, a lot of you guys were like, Ford, and I was like, yee. But check out my logo, guys. Isn't that dope? Look at that. It's pretty trippy, huh? Yeah. I'm gonna call this thing freaking Murder Machine. What do you guys think? And Mason also has a model of the same kind of truck. This one's like a 2012 F450, right? Single cab, which I have a. I still have multiple versions of this. This truck right here was based in off the red fuel edition one that I used to use. You know, the red F450 2012 single rear axle. I mean, single wheelbase, I'm sorry. And whatchamacallit. Yeah, it's based on literally the same truck. It's really good vehicle because this was like our upgrade, guys, to the other F450s that I had like 2 years ago, whatever, the red ones. If you guys are our long-term subscribers, you remember I had those red F450s. One of them was lifted up with black rims too. Well, this is kind of like the newer version, I guess you would say, of that. So please don't beat up on me as far as oh, this mod is not freaking finished. It's not finished. Pitanio, it's not finished. You know what I mean? Because you guys told me in the last couple videos that you wanted me to release, you know, the converts. You know what I mean? Y'all were like, release the converts. And also, you know, the other stuff when you get it done. And, or, you know, or what y'all wanted me to do is, what I'm trying to say right now is, like, y'all wanted me to release this stuff early. Because I'm still going to be working on this stuff. You know what I mean? Like, it's very in the early. But yeah, if we hit the like goal right here on this video, if we get 800 likes on this video, which is nothing for you guys. Whoa, Jesus, I gotta fix that. Lordy Lou. But yeah, check it out. Let's get in the old Toyota FJ. I went ahead and converted this to, oh, I forgot to fix the lights. And my light fix, guys, a lot of you guys have been asking the questions. Hey, when I convert a mod into 2017, my lights have like this box. Whoa, we're like, dude, the suspension on this thing is like whack mode. I don't know. It wasn't like this in 2015. It probably, it's something due to the convert, guys. But look at this thing. I mean, it's cool. Like, look at the tilt. The tilt's cool. It's very realistic. I guess, actually, I mean, I can, that's pretty cool, actually, now that I think about it. Because look, it dips. Like, when I turn right or left, it actually, like, dips. You know what I mean? Like, all I did was convert the one from 2015. Man, this thing works out really good. Check out the, oh, man, I gotta fix that, too. Why does that do that? It's been doing it for, like, every mod that I've downloaded, too. Like, not just ones that I've freaking converted or made. But, look. When I get to, like, a high speed, my chair, like, comes out of its seat or something. I don't know. Like, it's like the back of my car seat right here, guys. It, like, look at it. It's like Penn and Teller, Chris Angel type stuff. Never seen that before. But, yeah, we're taking this thing out for a testy run. And, once again, this is made by friggin' Unknown Modding. Petonio just friggin' did the convert and stuff. And Mason is actually working on a power wagon, and also he is going to be finishing this next week in a couple days and some change. Dude, this thing slides. I don't know. I think the center of gravity might be off. Yeah, because look, when I turn, guys, can you see it? But like, watch. It reminds me of a regular FJ, because I swear to God, guys, like, my friend had an FJ, and we almost flipped it. Like, me and him almost died in one of these cars. We were, you know, goofing off and stuff like that. I wasn't driving, but he was driving, and we were hitting, like, out in boondocks, you know, where, like, I guess, it's like farmland, but it's also, like, not farmland, I guess you'd say. Whoa. Okay, we just nitro circused into the freaking pond, guys. Let's go ahead and spawn us another one. Because we just straight up Brian Deegan 360 no scope X Games nitro circus mode into there. It's going to be our foam pit, guys. Oh, speaking of foam pit, check it out. This will also be in the description as well. So, what the stuff that you need to look for in the description is this right here, the commander, that ATV to the left of me, and Shulaboot. Where is it? Did I not buy it? I guess I didn't buy it. I gotta buy it, actually, guys. Sorry about that. Ba-da-do-do-do. Right here. The Kawasaki KLR650. This is the newest version of it, guys. Oh, we're gonna be doing some train hauling soon, everyone. It's gonna be really fun. Whoa, yeah, so this dude's center of gravity is messed up, too. Huh. Must be something with converts. Because look, see how he's leaning? It's weird. It's like he's driving. And this bike is like, needs to be scaled up heavily. It works a lot better than the previous version. The first KLS that got released for 17. Convert. Yeah, I'm just taking this thing off-road and stuff like that. See how the suspension does. Because I might be able to get an insight on why my mod is kind of doing the same thing. Whoa, you see the back tire, guys? Look at the back tire. Watch. Let me slow down. But yeah, guys, this is a camping video, but this video is kind of like a hybrid camping and off-roading video mixed in with, I guess you would say, like a mod showcase and a release, you know what I mean? Like, this video is like seven things in one, guys. That's why you should give it a big like and a comment. And we hit the 800 likes, I'm releasing the Tundra, another version of the Tundra. Oops, stop. Oh, brake lights. Yep, the dude, I just noticed that the brakes need to be a little on the friction side a little bit more, but I think that has to do with the back tire coming off the ground and the front tire sinking into the gravel, or I mean asphalt, like it's quicksand. It's crazy. Yep, he did the same fix as me. Like, okay, that I'm gonna teach. Do you guys want me to teach you how to fix the lights for a converted mod, guys? Because I can teach you. It takes like 5 seconds. Literally, like, took me like 3 hours to figure it out by myself, but I figured it out. And I pretty much, the only thing I don't understand, guys, is how sometimes when with the Can-Am over there, the yellow one, or any Can-Am, a lot of times it'll show up with like my farmer guy, but like another, fortunately, did not hit the goal, because it was around the time when all you kiddos were going back to skew. And yeah, so we're actually gonna be taking this trailer with this truck, and we're gonna be going to a different campsite. Here we go. Yeah, who do you think? This is a good, cool setup, guys. Cool setup. It's still in an alpha patent mode version, so you know, be careful with it. I don't know if I'm gonna release it in this video, because I'm releasing the Can-Am and also the RV. And I really thought, like, I kind of like, I'm pretty sure Giants made the Can-Am Lizard four-wheeler over there, right, guys? So I don't need to, like, whoa. This was weird. I hate when it does that, guys. You see what it just did? Ugh. That's the two main problems I have. The human centipede problem, and for vehicles, like trucks and cars, that. Like, random out of the blue, my camera will just, like, glitch like that. And even if I get back in, can't. See, can't. I don't know. It's weird. I even tried going in the XML, actually, guys, and typing true instead of false or something like that. Still didn't work. Okay, guys, I'm sorry if I'm kind of scatterbrained also. I've been up for like 28 hours just busting videos out and working on mods for you guys. Just like that little break that we just took, guys. Oh, by the way, I just converted the friggin' raptor. But, yeah, now this one's doing the human centipede. Look at this. Look at this. So crazy. Boom. Check out the scale. That's what I'm talking about when I said that the KLR right there looks like a gosh dang pit bike, man. Look at it. Look at her. We'll, perfect. Yes. Messed up. Oh, yeah, but look what I just did, guys. In the second cut that you go, oh, man, I forgot to fix the lights on the back. I knew I was forgetting something. But, yeah, guys, this is going to be saved for a later release since we didn't hit the goal. And the video for FS15 that I said if we hit the goal, I'd release both this truck and the Tundra. And like three or four versions of each of them too. But since we didn't, I'm still gonna release the Tundra, and then we're gonna try for another goal this video, like I've already stated. I don't wanna go into that again, I've said it twice already. But this right here, along with the other three versions, I mentioned earlier that we are creating a power wagon as well. So the three or four D250, 350, trucks that we have right now that I'm in the process of converting, those will be released upon a video, you know, we do with the power wagon. So I'm gonna release them as a bundle. I think it'd be really cool to release both the power wagons and the D250 350s. But yeah, guys, let's go take this sucker off road. See, he handles awesomely, because even though, like, I was stressed on time, like, that's why I forgot to fix the lights and stuff like that. And next couple videos, guys, I can show you guys, you know what I mean, how to fix the lights. Or if I got time at the end of this video, I will just do that. But, yeah, we gotta do that right now. We're already at 18 gigabytes, guys. I'm blowing through time, guys. Sorry about that. I really apologize. But yeah, this super long video, I'm sorry if we didn't get like a lot of particular stuff done. Like we didn't, you know, do like just primarily camping is what I'm trying to say, or like primarily camping and friggin' mudding. We did like camping, mudding, you know, everything, like I just said 2 seconds ago. But yeah, guys, that's gonna be about it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please give me a big like, comment, and subscribe. And tell your friends about the game, and tell your friends about the channel, because I'm going to be releasing great content almost daily. I plan on releasing videos daily, which I've been doing, besides like one day or something like that where I went like 20 hours without uploading. But I'm trying, guys. I'm working like 10-12 hours a day just on friggin' YouTube and some music stuff. So I'm dedicated to you guys. You guys are friggin' awesome. And yeah, so if you're still here for this video, I will have this little short segment right here. I'm gonna play it now to show you guys how to fix the lights. Most common question. Just check it out and tell people. If you see them ask this question in the comment section, hey Patton, how do you fix lights? Be like, yo, check out this vid. Alright? Alright, guys. Later. Swahili, everybody. Did you freaking miss me? I sure missed you. Alright, next up. Friggin' go on the file button right there, and go ahead and open your mode, and make sure your freaking mode is in it's in a zip, because you'll only be able to pull up the i3D if it's not in a friggin' zip. So with that, we're gonna do the D250, because I messed up and I rushed and I didn't do it. And the see how it says select mod item right there? Go ahead and okie dokie. And you may get some errors down here, but unless they're not really bad or nothing like that, you ain't got to really worry. I got errors with my turs. I got my Toyos. Check them out. Look how sexy them bitches are. Look at them. Ooh. I love these. It makes me freaking drool. You see all the white boxes, guys? And apologize, this video is probably long as crap already, so, like, I don't know. I just why not just make it in this video, since we already did like everything, you know what I mean? We didn't just do camping, we did everything, so why not add one more thing? All right, see in the left, make sure to maximize that freaking Dodge Cummings. I'm just trolling y'all just there. But no, just maximize that 1990 Dodge Cummins, not Cummings. And anything that you see that says light, make sure to friggin' uncheck the visibilitors in it. And yeah, go to front light first. So I already have the visibilitors off. And light deco, make sure to take him off, light decoration. And then friggin' brake lights. See, look, watch my mouse. Pew, boop. Do that to everyone, or you could just do it to the actual, like, whatchamacallit. I can't even think of the name. I'm that scatterbrained right now from no sleep. The hierarchy. There we go. Fancy word right there, Peyton. Yeah, the hierarchy is what my mouse is on right here. This is the hierarchy. I don't know where I got that word from, but yeah, that's what all I could think of to describe it. But yeah, make sure to check all those out. Reverse lights. That's how scatterbrained I am right now. And I this is the second time I recorded this tutorial right here. I just recorded like 5 minutes ago, but Camtasia was like, wrong codec, da-na-na-na-na. And I was like, oh my god, dude, you wouldn't do that. Boom, done. Look, check it out. Just reverse light. That's all you gotta do. Reverse light, brake lights, turning lights, and big lights. And decoration lights if you got them. And exhaust particles. That's about it. And if you have issues where it says like you have issues with like the colon or something like that, freaking colon cancer, I don't know, that's what it freaking told me one time, but it don't say it no more. See, check it out. It just says I can't have hidden files, and that's probably because like when Mason made this truck, he freaking hid the files. Or locked it, whatever you want to call it. You know, potato. Alright, that's about it, guys. You can either go ahead and save it, boom, done. Or you can exit out and do that. Squandarlo. But yeah, that, guys, that's going to be about it. Later, peace.